Welcome to Serial Killers at Sacred Fools. Serial Killers at Sacred Fools.
Something strange is happening to gay men in
the Instigate, episode 2!
In the words of our beloved Judy, bitch need a drink.
Oh! Why do you keep doing that?
Hi, I'm Jerry.
I know. We've met. You said your name twice. It was upsetting.
Cool. Do you know where Matt is?
No.
Thanks, man.
Wait! How's your night going?
Do you wish to engage in social discourse of a personal and intimate nature?
Sure.
I'm here.
Okay, so like, what's your deal, man? I mean, you have a jawline that could get you through the door, but this whole creepy serial killer vibe, hashtag name drop, is prominent. So like I said, what is your deal?
Not entirely unpleasant demeanor.
Thanks. It's yoga twice a week and omega-3s, which is this gay bar where power bottoms enjoy group sex right by my Adderall.
Your face is aesthetically pleasing. I'd like to take it off your skull. I mean, I'd like to put it in my pocket. I mean, it's good. I like it.
You know, you're right. My face is aesthetically pleasing. What do you think of my mustache? You can be honest.
It's retro, vintage, a third synonym. I'm Jerry.
And I grew it because my boyfriend broke up with me. He used to never let me have facial hair because he was into humpback whaling. Do I let men dictate my life? Dictate. <Yeah.
laughs> To fill that hole in your life.
I do use alcohol. It does fill that hole. I also use chocolate and sex, and on one drunken occasion, chocolate sex, which is a very specific category of gay porn. Oh, probably not the one you're thinking. Oh my god, am I a cliche? I use sex with men to fill the hole in my life.
I use sex with men to fill the hole in my butt.
So you're a bottom. Good to know.
You should be kinder to yourself. There's a space in you that no man has ever reached.
Well, that's probably not true. One time I slept with a Harlem Globetrotter. There's a...
Serial Killers at Sacred Fools.